Crossing from British Columbia into the Yukon territories meant that we had reached the 60th parallel of latitude. We were both pretty excited to have made it this far and marveled at the sheer size of British Columbia, the province that we had been exploring for the last 3 weeks. So we topped off our fuel tanks and headed towards Watson Lake, the first place we would visit in the Yukon.
Well, this is Paul, Endless Trail Expeditions. We've finally arrived in the Yukon at Watson Lake. And at Watson Lake, their notoriety is this incredible, what they call the signpost forest. It's just a gigantic area full of signposts from literally all over the world. I mean, I've just started at the very outset, but it just goes on and on and on. It's amazing, just amazing. Okay, this is Paul and Maggie from Endless Trail Expeditions, and we're reporting from the Cambell Highway that runs from Watson Creek in the Yukon Territory up north and eventually connects up with the lower sections of the Dempster Highway. As I think most of you know, we're on our way to the Arctic Circle and eventually to Tuktoyaktuk on the Arctic Ocean. So check out the trail here. We're on the Cambell Highway. Heading north in Yukon territories. As you can see, and this is the main road. This is the main road. You certainly don't want to be broken down on this road. I think this particular section is 500 miles, something like that. And yeah. On with the journey. Continuing along the Cambell Highway in Yukon Territories. And here's my co-pilot. Say hi, co-pilot. She says she's tired. The Robert Cambell Highway is about 550 miles long, with one fuel stop about 250 miles in. Fortunately, BAT has the fuel capacity to run the entire road without filling up, but I can't help but think about the challenges this would present in my Land Rover, for example. And you certainly do not want to be breaking down on this stretch of road. We'll be right back.
The same Dempster Highway, in quotes, is a dirt road of approximately 550 miles one way that takes you from just east of Dawson City in the Yukon to Tuktoyaktuk on the Arctic Ocean in the Northwest Territories. Once you get to Tuk, as it's usually called, you have to return by the same route, making it an 1,100-mile dirt road trip. We had arrived at the beginning of the Dempster Highway fairly late in the day, and so decided that our first night's camp should be at the earliest suitable spot. This old gravel pit served our purposes, as it was off the road and fairly level. The next day, the Dempster Highway continued to show its true beauty.
This spot of civilization is Eagle Plains, where you can purchase gas, food, and very expensive Wi-Fi.
Emergency airstrip on roadway. Well, this is Paul and Maggie from Endless Trail Expeditions, and we're about 10 odd miles south of the Arctic Circle. And I don't know if you just saw that road sign back there, but there's an emergency airstrip kilometer away. I'm assuming it's that straight section up there. Yeah, there's a windsock there, I can see it now. Looks like we're actually on the runway now. Pretty cool. There was a sign back there that said no stopping or parking on the runway. So that's on the runway. What's that? Oh, over there, yes, I see it. Well, this is our third day, or third, what will be our third day, or third evening on the Dempster Highway. And we are within 2 kilometers of crossing the Arctic Circle. We'll be reporting from that location. And look what we have here. It is, in fact, finally, on our third day, the Arctic Circle sign.
Reaching the sign marking the Arctic Circle was pretty special for us, so we had to celebrate as one does when achieving such a great accomplishment. As evening drew near and the Arctic fog closed in, we reached the Northwest Territories, and it was time for us to look for our next night's camp spot.
Now, this is Paul and Maggie from Endless Trail Expeditions reporting this morning from Northwest Territories, and we're rapidly... you just heard it there on the nav. We're close to Fort McPherson, an old British trading post, I believe, and we are about to cross the Peel River on a ferry. So this is going to be kind of interesting. Let's see how this goes. The ferry's on the other side, and there's a load of cars boarding the ferry right now, and we'll just have to wait our turn when he comes to this bank. Pretty cool. I believe it's a free in air quotes service provided by the Canadian government for using your taxes instead of building a bridge. I don't know how many bats it can take, but I'm sure we'll find out shortly.
Please drive to highlighted route.
Mm-hmm.
cable driven, so there's some kind of winch arrangement that is pulling the cable back and forth. Yeah. You can hold it to show the view then. Pretty cool. Crossing the Peel River. And there is our fearless operator. Paul and Maggie from Endless Trail Expeditions on our fourth day on our Arctic expedition. And look at this. The Mackenzie River, the mighty Mackenzie River. And we will be embarking on a ferry to cross this river, which will be our second ferry today. Pretty awesome. Look at that view. Just look at that view. There's the ferry, but where's it going? Did we miss it? It looks like he's going for lunch.
For the ferry.
No, it's over there, right in front of it. Let's read what it says. I don't know where he's going. He's all the way over there. And I think it's... the crossing is over there where the cars are parked on the other side of the road. So we'll have to observe. Well, the ferry's coming in, but
it's taking a sweet old time.
But Maggie, can you tell us how you would do it differently?
I said he's taking his sweet old time because it's not really that hard. It's just a very short passage here, and he would just like zip it over. But no, yeah,
that's,
I guess it's 1-800 pay the same. So.
Yeah, that's years of Raytheon experience there. Mm-hmm. Describing how this is, he's making a simple journey complicated. Well, thank you, Maggie, for that insight.
An hour later, we're still waiting, still waiting.
We've been here now some 45 minutes or so, and this guy is coming in at quite an interesting angle. Looks like this guy decided he wants to go back again in the Jeep. Is that what he's saying? I think he wants me in the middle, but I'm not sure.
In 1.5 miles, leave the ferry.
You want me on the left-hand side? On the right-hand side? Okay. That's it. We're on board. Look at that. About to cross the Mackenzie River landing craft style. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Thank you.
I thought we were going over there. Process is taking quite a long time. The ferry dropped off a construction vehicle, and then because we were parked right at the front of the ferry was tipped down too much because of our weight, and so they had to move vehicles off behind us so that we could reverse back a bit. I did wonder about that when they boarded us, but you know, they waved me right on to the front, so what do you do? Anyway, now we're back a little bit, as you can see, and it looks like we're finally making progress towards the other bank.
Well, after what seemed like about 2 hours in total process, we did reach the opposite river bank and were able to continue our journey onward to the town of Inuvik. To celebrate our arrival in Inuvik, Maggie and I decided to eat out at a rather unique restaurant where the kitchen was actually located in an old school bus next to a hut containing the seating area. While dumping tanks may be normal, what is interesting in this picture are the above ground drains, which can be seen everywhere north of the Arctic Circle. We were unsure of the fuel situation in Tuktoyaktuk, so we topped off our tanks in Inuvik and headed north. The road continued over the vast Arctic tundra until finally, off in the distance, we started to catch glimpses of the Arctic Ocean. And then, all of a sudden, we entered the outskirts of Tuktoyaktuk.
Beautiful downtown Tuktoyaktuk. Restaurant and lodging. Bob's Welding.
And then, in what seemed like a sudden moment, we could see the vast Arctic Ocean before us. We had reached the top of the world. We had driven as far north as is possible. We had achieved the dream.
Well, Bat is finally at the Arctic Ocean. All the way. He's driven 5,600 miles, albeit a somewhat circuitous route to get here, but he's here. two travelers, one awesome truck. There he is. And there is the Arctic Ocean. It's looking a bit grey and cold, mind you. Now, am I to breathe a sigh of relief because it says no swimming over there?
Right then, our friends Rainer and Elfie arrived with us at the top of the world, and we spent the rest of the evening with them, eating, drinking, and celebrating our collective achievement.